I've been testing a very cool plugin for Premiere Pro, which is called Film Convert Nitrate. It helps you add grain to your footage, it's very customizable, and you can also achieve a very nice color grading fast. So here we are in Premiere Pro. I selected some clips that I shot last year, and let's see how this plugin works. As I said, you can use it to add grain and also color grade your footage. And usually when I do this, I like to add an adjustment layer that will affect all the clips from below. So I'm just going to drag and drop the Film Convert Nitrate plugin on this adjustment layer first. As you can see, it loads up as any other effect in Premiere Pro, and in my opinion, it's well structured. You have different panels, so let's start with the first one, which is this area called Camera Settings. This is very nice because you can select the camera that you recorded the footage with. So in my case, I will go with Canon. Then you can select the model. You have some different options here in the drop-down list, so I will choose EOS R. And then, if you shot the footage using log, you have a few options here as well for profiles. And as I remember, I was using the neutral color space, so I will choose that. After applying the settings, you may see your footage changing in contrast and exposure, but don't worry, be happy, because we can tweak these settings and I will show you how. You have sliders for exposure, white balance, and tint, but before adjusting these, I would recommend to choose a film stock first from this list. So basically, all these presets are emulating older film looks, and depending on what you choose from this list, your footage will look different. You even have a few black and white presets, but for these clips, I will choose the Fuji Vivid 8543, and you can instantly see the color grading and grain that was applied on my clips. The awesome part is that you have control over the intensity of the colors by modifying this film chroma value between 0 and 100, but also for the lightness of the film stock with the help of the film Luma. So, maybe you just want to add a nice vintage grading without affecting the exposure of the original footage. The colors and exposure are separated, and I like working like this. And we can check a before and after as well, pressing on this FX button, so you can see how the footage looked like before. For the film size, I always choose 35mm full frame because I filmed on my Canon EOS R. Let's talk about the grain now, because this is an area where you have a lot of control in this plugin. Not everybody likes grain, even if it's very different from the noise generated by the high ISO in the cameras. Some people don't like it, but I do. I shoot photos as well, and depending on the color grading, sometimes I add some grain. In fact, when you watch a movie at the theater, I'm sure you noticed grain on the image. So you can control the size of the grain, the softness, the strength, allowing you to disable it completely if you don't need any grain on your footage. You can have a clean footage with just a nice film emulation, and that's it. What's cool about the grain panel is this graph on the left side that's allowing you to selectively add different amounts of grain in the shadows, midtones, or highlights. I have the shadows here on the left, and you can see that if I push this point up, the grain will be more visible in the dark areas. If I have a brighter scene like this one, I can choose to have more grain in the highlights. So again, how much grain you add and where is up to you. You can experiment and decide what you like. It's that simple. And then is this color grading section where you have control over the brightness of the shadows, midtones, and highlights. So with the help of the Lumetri scopes, you can easily nail the perfect exposure for your shots. You can tweak the color grading by changing the colors using these three wheels. So for example, I can easily add some blue tones into the shadows here, and then I can also push the midtones more into this orange area here. I find it very useful that they added two more ways to control the exposure and the contrast with the help of the curves, but also levels. So, if for example I want to brighten up the image, I can drag this mid-tone slider from the levels more to the left side, and the image becomes brighter. Or, the same thing here, using curves, I can create a point in the mid-tones and make the image brighter, or I can tweak the shadows area even more, while taking a look at the Lumetri scopes in the bottom left of the screen. I rendered out the footage from my timeline just to make it easier for you to see some before and afters, and then I will be back with some more details about this plugin. So leave me a comment below and tell me if you like this look and if you are that type of video editor or creator who sometimes likes to add some grain to the final look. the coolest part, in my opinion, is that you can export the final look as a LUT and use it on other projects. So this could be a way for anyone to create LUTs. And the Film Convert Nitrate plugin can also be used in After Effects, DaVinci Resolve, and Final Cut. Not only that, but as I can see on their website, you can even download the plugin and try it for yourself before you decide if you want to buy it or not. So if you ask me, yes, I will use this plugin because it's really fun, and oftentimes in the past I searched for different ways to add grain to my footage, and this plugin offers me the flexibility to change how the grain will look like. I'm a person who loves sliders, a person who loves options, and the ability to change different parameters when using a plugin. Now, if you enjoyed this video, maybe you'll love this one right here. I'm Chris, thanks a lot for watching. Have a great week and see you in the next video. Bye-bye now.